So here is the selection of my hooks. This is everything I have in my collections. And there are very obviously I put them into groups. So these are my Chaogu crochet hooks, and they have a aluminum tip. And then the handle is actually a bamboo, but it's a flat handle, you can see. I have another bamboo hooks. So they are just regular feature that has a hook tip and throat, and then you have the body of your hook, and it actually carved out a little bit of space for you to know where to put your fingers at. And I also have some metal hooks. That's this three and this three. And the only difference between them is that this one is one end. This one is double-ended. And I also have a bunch of plastic. These are plastic hooks. So they are light. They are very, very light. And I only use them for larger sizes. And I also have these hooks that are elastomer resin handled. So this is from Hamanaka. And they are made with a resin handle that is shaped into triangular. And this one is double-ended, but you can find some other brand that is single-end. But I just so happen to have this set, and so far the one I use the most. For your crochet hook, there are so many materials. So you have so many options. There are so many different type of handles. So you see that this is a regular round handle. There are handles that has grip for you to put fingers on. And there are, you see Chaogu has a very big handle, and also there are resin handles. So how do you know which hooks are good for you? There are actually different pros and cons in each and every kind of hooks. And what you want to do is that you want to find a hook that suit the way that you work. So in the later lessons, I'm going to talk about how you will be holding a hook and how you will be holding yarns, and those will determine what kind of hook you will want to use. But basically, for plastic hooks, they are lightweight, so they are very easy to handle. But it also has the downside, which that plastic is a little bit grippy to some yarns. So you might have difficulty hooking in one point of time. But this is but if you want something that's light and that's not adding weight to your wrist, then plastic hook is a good choice. And it comes in a wide range of sizes, and you can find them very cheaply in dollar stores. So price-wise, this is perfect. And if you want something that is not as slidey, so like if you have, for example, this metal hook. So metal, they're very slippery. It will be very fast for you to work, but it is a little bit heavier. Even this smaller size is heavier than a plastic hook that's large size. But it's a very slippery shaft, so it's very easy for you to hook. However, if your yarn is silk or your yarn is cotton and it's already a very slippery yarn, you probably won't want to use a metal hook. Let's say if you have very slippery yarn and you do not want plastic, then you can go with some bamboo or wood hooks. And they are sanded down very well. So it's good to work. It's still slidey and it's still slippery for the yarn to pass through easily. But then it's made of bamboo, and so it does give you a little extra grip compared to a metal hook. And for hooks that has different kind of handle, like this, I will say it comes to a personal choice. So if you like to hold something that is flat and that gives you security and that is comfortable for you, then go ahead with the bamboo handle. So it really depends on the way that you hold a hook, and we'll talk about that later. And you will need to experience yourself. Or if you choose to have a elastomer resin handle, then this gives you a nice grip. So it's not as slidey as a metal hook like this. This is a complete metal hook. And this is just bamboo. And this is just plastic. So they're all round in shape. And then they might not be as comfortable to hold for a long time. So that's why Hamanaka designed one that has a triangular grip, and it has some of imprint on it, so it's not like your hand is not sliding up and down when you're working. But you still have metal tip that gives you a very nice movement when you are crocheting. So to begin with your hook choices, I will suggest you to find a hook that is convenient to you to get. So if you have dollar store right beside you, go get a dollar store crochet hook to start. If you have a yarn shop that provides some of the hook selection, and go and choose a yarn that is in the price that it's good for you. And then it looks nice. Sometimes I choose hook because it has pretty colors. But for whatever hook that you decided to use, your first hook, I will highly suggest to just be something that's easy to get. Like, for example, for me, when I started, my mom gave me this, double-ended hooks, metal hooks. So I inherited from my mom, and that's the only one I have for the first 2 years of crocheting. And for this kind of double-ended hook, they work great for me, but they have one downside is that it has another end. So sometimes when you're working and when your project get larger, this hook cut onto your project. So when you are choosing a double-ended hook, yes, you have less hook in your selection. Like imagine if all this are one-ended, I'll have 8 more hooks in my collection if they are all single-end. But because they have them double-ended, I have less hook in my stash. But you just want to be careful that knowing this hook will cause you some trouble if you're not careful and you're not familiar with them. And so it really is your personal choice whether you want to get this kind of hook. This kind of hook with an elastomer handle is the kind of hook that I can hold the longest without feeling tired, at least for me. So there are many, many different brands out there, and they have their pros and cons in each kind of hook. And you just want to make sure you start with something easy. And then when you are using it, doing all the mini practice we're going to have, then you will know what kind of feature you want your hook. You want a heavy hook, you want a light hook, you want a metal hook, you want a bamboo hook, you want different shape of handles. And I will highly encourage you to try out as many as possible, so then you will know which hooks work the best for you. And just make sure that when you're holding the hooks, you are very relaxed. So this is the important thing when you are looking for a hook. Your hands is relaxed and you're comfortable holding it. And if it's making you uncomfortable, if your wrist started to get sore very fast, then that either means your hand is too tight, you shouldn't hold your hook very tightly, or that this hook is just not suitable.